John Archibald Wheeler once said that time is just nature's way of stopping everything from happening at once. As if the universe had a limited amount of bandwidth or a low RAM, like an early 80s game console. Certainly without time, things would make a lot less sense than they already do. And there's a whole host of reasons why time travel wouldn't work. If flutter toys flap their wings to make hurricanes, then crash landing a DeLorean in the Cretaceous is going to derail every little step of the pathway. From the garage where you build the thing in the first place, fuck around to your parents fucking before an open fire on their second date. But which scientists, right? Open like new flowers to inquiry, to the universe, new ideas, a new paradigm. And it might just be that our under-evolved A-brain can't yet conceive the permutations and contortions of logic that could lead from how we understand the world now to how it could be, to the wormholes and shortcuts that might throw Einstein for a loop and make the whole thing somehow impossibly possible. So here's the deal. You have a time machine. The question is, what are you going to do with it?
You have to make plans of yourself with a paper and pen. On your way through every top 40 instance of your brain started and make a list of all the words, remember the tunes. Make sure you have it all written down. Send the dolls away you're heading to the year before all this 1952. Welcome to your alternative life. You are the king of rock and roll. It's about to be on. You have the songs, you are the king of radio. Create every person like you knew exactly which way to go. It just seems to be effortless, the way you run them in 10 minutes or less. A bit of nominees can't explain how you took their inner secrets and spilled them out your mouth before they can write them down.
But wait a minute. Seriously, wait a minute. This has happened before. I swear this has happened before. There were those two weird kids from Liverpool. They came out of nowhere. Wait a minute. John and Paul something.
Paul McCartney and John Lennon came back from a different future. I'll break the works filled up with songs stored from kids who now stay at home. Paul McCartney and John Lennon came back from a different future. I'll with numbers filled up with songs stored from kids who now stay at home. Bob Chapman was sent back in time to assassinate John Lennon. Paul is left with a question.